I mean, you know, he's the first president since 1968 to step down. I think it shows what a statesman he is. Mm-hmm. I think it shows what a patriot he is. I think it shows that he can put his country before his ego, because he had such a great record as president. I think that history will note him as one of the greatest presidents that we've had.
I mean, I can't even listen to all of this. It's like, I cannot listen to that level of fakery. I mean, that's what they're... The stuff that she's saying is ridiculous. That's what's-her-face. So from The View, welcome back to the program. Dana Loesch here, top of the second hour. You can listen coast to coast. You can stream the radio program as well. Watch the simulcast. If he was such a great statesman, why did he wait to like Ruth Bader Ginsburg levels of time before dropping out? I mean, he drops out after all other potential possibilities of switching out the ticket seamlessly. All of those deadlines had passed. I mean, if he's such a statesman, why did he wait that long? If he's such a statesman, you know, if he's such a put, if he's a guy that puts ego last, why did he wait until literally the last minute to do anything? And actually, I would say that minute has passed because of all the deadlines. I mean, she can't get her money on any, her hands on any of his PAC money. She only gets the Biden-Harris stuff. She's, you know, they've got to work hard at making sure, because you can secure all the delegates you want, but you got to make sure you got the super delegates as well. It's still going to be, you're still essentially going into kind of an open convention technically. And none of the voters had voted for her. How is it statesman to undo and just throw out all of your voters, the votes that they cast in primaries and caucuses around the country? That's what Biden is doing. Democrats picked him and in the primary, they voted for him, and he's just doesn't care. He's just jettisoning that out of the window. He didn't care. But I don't know. It's pretty amazing that these are the people that always go on and on about democracy and everything else, but yet they're not participating in it with their own voters. We talked about that yesterday. It is the end of the Democrat Party, as you know. It's a weird situation, a very weird situation. And you have them, they're all, you know, they're voting. She's got the most of the delegates at this point now. Biden speaking from the Oval Office tomorrow at 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 Central. And... I don't know. Kane points out, makes a good point. The New York Times on July, this was July 12th. They wrote, quote, "For years, far-right commentators have floated a conspiracy theory that Democrat Party elites were secretly plotting to replace Biden on the ticket. And now those conspiracists are using the moment to lend credibility to their work." Fast forward to the 22nd. Many elected Democrats announced their support for Vice President Kamala Harris to lead the ticket hours after Biden stepped out of the race. That's exactly what they did. It's those people that are, it's the Democrat Party elites. That's exactly who it is. Democrat Party elites. Ooh, boy. I'm telling you what, this is something else. We're going to see how all this goes. What happened in Vegas? According to a March 2024 report from the Association of American Medical Colleges, the U.S. is facing a shortage of 86,000 doctors by 2036. Already, wait times to see a doctor nearly reach 4 weeks. That's a troubling trend set to worsen. And your alternative? Lengthy hours in the ER or urgent care amid a whole crowd of ill people. Yeah, no. Take control of your own health care. Order a medical emergency kit from the Wellness Company. Now, this is not, I repeat, it's not a first aid kit. It's like having an urgent care in your home. It's super handy. It comes with doctor-prescribed medicines for over 30 medical issues, antibiotics for infections, strep throat, I've used it, pneumonia, bronchitis, all kinds of stuff. Match your symptoms to the prescription in your booklet and take the correct meds now to get well faster. There's no waiting for a doctor or a pharmacy or being around tons of sick people. Every home should have at least one medical emergency kit, and you can order yours online in literally minutes. Get 15% off at twc.health/Dana and use promo code Dana. That's promo code Dana at twc.health/Dana. Vegas, when Biden was there, he had that one event where he was out touching everybody, and then literally the next day, they're like, oh, he's got COVID. Jordan Satchel was saying that something was happening there. He said he delivered the keynote address at the NAACP. It was at the Mandalay Bay Hotel. He looked horrible. He looked angry and horrible. And he was going to deliver a keynote at the MGM Grand on that Wednesday. And he did not appear. And in fact, he didn't go to the scheduled keynote that he was going to give on Wednesday. And that was with Unidos, their annual convention at the MGM Grand. He didn't go there. And instead, he went for his Delaware beach house. And he has stayed there. He had several events later. I'm looking at this. He gave his speech. That was on Tuesday, Wednesday, he canceled that address and all the other events that evening, went to his Delaware beach house, and he's still there. And then he announces on social media, he's not running for president. He's backing Harris. No one has seen a photo of him. No one has seen a video of him. He apparently participated on a telephone call, although it sounded weird. And then they said, oh no, he had to change everything because he got COVID. Really? Oh yeah, he's got COVID. That's it. Just cold-like symptoms. But then we had the audio that we played the other day where his brother, Jim, had given a quote to the press where he said, you know, with the time that we have left, you know, like he made it sound like Biden was on death's door. It was very weird. Now people are trying to. There's some rumors going around that, you know, maybe it was a medical emergency, something like that. There's been a lot of back and forth on social media about this because he was all, I don't know. It's who do you believe? This is why you got to be very careful when you're on the right too with bad information. Apparently though, some of the police that were working as local law enforcement for his trip out to Vegas were saying that it was already chaotic and that he was already very, very behind schedule that day. And when he was at the Mexican restaurant, that's where the video is from, where he's walking around shaking everybody's hands. They said that he was already behind schedule when he was doing that. And then he was supposed to head out and then deliver that speech, and it was all canceled. And they said the story that Satchel says, that law enforcement officers on duty were informed over the radio that he was dealing with an unspecified medical situation, which sounds a little bit more than just COVID. Some say that it was easily hundreds of Las Vegas metropolitan officers and employees who heard that radio conversation live. And they said that the dispatches suggested that this was more than just a change of plans and that it was something a little more serious. And they said that they were coordinating with the president's detail. The radio dispatchers responsible for that had demanded a surge of law enforcement resources into the area to secure the vicinity and expedite his movement. And his motorcade initially was planning on heading to UMC, University Medical Center, and then they said that they were rerouting. It was weird. There was a local NBC affiliate, and this is the story that they had. I'm pulling this up. I'm going to drop this in Slack for the crew too. This was the story that they had. They were saying Las Vegas Hospital on standby to treat President Biden during COVID-19 diagnosis. They said that they were already on standby. They were alerted about a possible medical issue with Biden on Wednesday afternoon when he was visiting Southern Nevada. The story from News 3 Las Vegas said law enforcement and medical teams gathered outside of the University Medical Center trauma room in Wellness Way in the event that he arrived after he canceled an appearance at the Unidos convention in Vegas after testing positive for COVID. they said that the CEO of the of UNIDOS had, had made the announcement to the convention goers there that he was not going to be speaking. Now, they said he did not seek medical treatment at the hospital, but instead went to the airport and departed Vegas on Air Force One to self-isolate at his home in Delaware. They said the hospital was alerted about 2:15 about a potential medical issue with the president. They didn't have any other details, etc. It's very weird. They said that that they were involved, that they were in contact with, I guess, Biden's team, you know, the security officials that he had that were expediting his movement. Very weird. And then they didn't bring him to the hospital. And then apparently the plans changed again. Then they had to have a clear way, satchel notes, to get to the Harry Reid International Airport. And then the police assigned the president's detail and the emergency in the box squads. They had to redeploy all their resources to expedite that. Now, one of the senior White House correspondents for the Daily Mail, Emily Gooden, via this report over at Dossier Today, had said that Air Force One, quote, flew so fast that the plane shook and arrived in Dover in just 3 hours and 48 minutes. That's a pretty quick flight. And that's when he was seen. When it returned in Dover, she is the one that has the videos. And Juan showed you those videos before. Those are the videos where he's standing on the steps of the plane and he stops because he's almost evaluating whether or not he can get down. And he looks really bad, really bad. And he has a guy behind him and it's just really weird. Now, I don't know. Maybe the plane shook because there was turbulence. I don't know. But there are a lot of questions from this. The officers that were speaking to the press said that the way that the security around Biden was reacting was that it was like a major medical emergency. And that seems to betray the stated basic COVID light cold symptoms that they said that he had. I mean, that's weird, right? It's weird. And he looked very unsteady when he was getting off of that plane. So I don't know. There's some really interesting questions surrounding this. And it doesn't help that we haven't seen him. Not even a photograph. Haven't seen him on video. Haven't anything. And you know, tonight is going to be a pre-taped thing. It's not going to be a live address. Kane, this is not going to be a live address. Or not tonight. Sorry, tomorrow night. Tomorrow night's address is not going to be live.
Don't make it look like it is, though.
But it's not going to be live. It's weird. And then he calls into Kamala's event. He doesn't. I mean, I know that they have the video technology. You know, if Joe Biden needs help with video, maybe he can ask Hunter. Hunter's really good at recording stuff and putting it online. Right? I mean, he couldn't even do like a video appearance. It's just weird. And you can't blame people for asking these questions because it's weird. I mean, you can't create a sketchy situation and then get mad when people are like, that's sketch. You can't get mad at him for that. Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.